Multiple myeloma is a devastating malignancy. It affects about 25,000 Americans each year. Because it's incurable, it poses a particular challenge in terms of the number of different treatments that patients need to take for a very long period of time to keep the disease under control. We've had amazing progress. It's always surprising to me year on year how much progress happens in this field and in a very rapid manner. I think some of the more interesting advances are going to be newer drugs from different drug classes that have previously not been explored in myeloma. One of them is selinexor. It is a drug that targets XPO1, and it appears to be effective in patients who have failed everything. Another drug that is very interesting is venetoclax, a BCL2 inhibitor, which appears to work in a highly specialized subset of myeloma, the T1114 myeloma, where up to 50% of patients appear to respond to the single agent. With the number of regimens out there, you could legitimately say a physician could use any one of 20 different regimens for the treatment of newly diagnosed myeloma. But myeloma is a rare disease, and for the average practitioner in the field who sees two or three myeloma patients a year, it'll be very daunting to pick from 20 options. And this is where the how I treat segment is important, where you get non-conflicted, true disease experts to come and say, given all that we know, this is how I would manage the patient. For those of you who are interested in multiple myeloma and the management of this disease, I invite you to join me at the ASH meeting on Hematologic Malignancies in Chicago.